gum would cover up the cigarettes we smoked. The 7-Up would balance out the beer. Mom would make us dinner and we'd all try not to choke. Dad was working later every year. We count the trucks on Highway 1 on their way to Jacksonville, wondering where they headed on from there. My brothers and my sister all stood spiritually still, as if those roads became the answer to their prayers. But I didn't want it any other way. This town was the one thing that felt right. All these tourists could be kings during the day, but not in St. Augustine at night. I was working at the bait shack, supplying all the fishing tours. Pretty soon I was chartering a boat. My dad said I needed dumb luck and a secret stash of Coors if I stood a chance at keeping things afloat. That's when my girlfriend told me there's a baby on the way, and I need to know you're gonna go to bat. Well, I never put off till tomorrow the things I should have done today. No, I've always waited way longer than that. I have never had much say in how I felt. I've been guided by my ballroom appetites. So if this world belongs to everybody else, just leave me St. Augustine at night. The Lord must really love us common folk, 'cause he made so goddamn much. Now if he'd just point the way to go, if he could just start speaking up. Our oldest brother left this world for leading once in many lives. I guess he settled for none at all. The rest of us just grew apart and blamed our husbands and our wives when anyone was asked why they don't call. Life became a series of birthdays, cars, and pets. Just anything to look forward to. I don't talk about mistakes, I don't talk about regrets. At this point, I'm not sure what good it would do. And I'm not asking for anybody's help as I gaze out where the stars dance with the lights. If I'm not sure how I feel about myself, I still got St. Augustine at night. Oh, I still got St. Augustine at night.